What's up, all you wonderful cripples and non-cripples out there? Welcome to my channel. My name is Dan Bartley, and this is... I've just noticed. My beard is extremely long and very ginger. This past week, I had a delivery come that I've been waiting for ages, and, well, I've been waiting to purchase it for ages, but I just didn't have the money. Unfortunately, I've been feeling a bit under the weather. I had really bad sinusitis. Still got it a little bit, still a little bit bunged up, so I apologise if all you can hear is sniffles. But, yeah, I thought I'd review this product now. I've had it working for, well, the past week now. I just didn't feel up to doing a video on it. But today I thought I'd do a video on it. Now, you know what it is already from the title of the video. But here we have the new... Cue the sound effects. That's right. The Echo Dot. I have already had this set up. I have put it back in the box so I can show you the unboxing process, kind of. So anyway, let's just read what it says on the back. Designed around your voice, Echo Dot connects to Alexa, which is a cloud-based voice service that is always getting smarter. Just ask and Alexa will provide information, play music, read the news, set alarms, control smart home devices, and more. You can add voice control to your speakers, which I'll show you in a minute. Connect to speakers over Bluetooth or with an audio cable, which is an aux cable to the UK people. I don't know if it's called an aux cable in America or any other part of the world. And you can stream music directly from Spotify, TuneIn, Amazon Music, and Pandora, and much more. Farfield voice recognition. With 7 microphones, beamforming technology, and noise cancellation, Echo Dot hears you from across the room and responds through the built-in speaker or a connected speaker. Can't speak. Voice control your smart home. Now, I have set one of them up as well, so I'll show you that in a minute. Ask Alexa to turn on your lights, adjust the temperature, or control over Wi-Fi connected home devices. From Netatmo, Philip Hue bulbs and more. Oh, sorry, and Wemo and more. I've had this working for a week, and I find it does say what it says on the box, which is I'm really happy about. Here's some examples. The wake word you have to use is Alexa. A lot of people have had a thing about, oh, I don't really want anything from the internet that's listening to my voice and listen to all our conversations. Good thing about it, she won't activate. I keep saying she. It's a gadget. She won't activate until you say the wake word, which is Alexa. By default, that's Alexa. You can change it in case you have a daughter or someone, a member of the family called Alexa, Alexi or something. You can change it to either Amazon or Echo as well. But I just stayed with the default. So anyway, let's... Oh, hold on. More on the side. Yeah, here we are. Skills including Amazon Music, Spotify. You can order stuff from Just Eat. You can read your Sky Sports. You can... Wemo plugs. The friends of Philip Hue. And Hive. And they can read The Guardian and much more. Certain services are subject to change or withdrawal at any time, may not be available in all areas, and may require separate subscriptions. Yeah, let's just open the box anyway. What do you have here? Oh yeah. A list of commands you can ask her. It's double-sided. Just some things to try. Example, music, shows, podcasts, and radio. alarms and timers, and you can shop by Amazon. Questions and answers, news, weather and traffic, smart home, which is the thing I want to show you in a minute, and use these anytime, which is, you can pair Bluetooth. Evie, go to bed. Sorry, there was a cat outside the window. You pair your Bluetooth speaker and you can ask it to stop, and you can say volume 5, but the volume only goes up to 1 and 10. So we'll read that in a minute. Next, we have the getting started instructions, but I'll talk you through that anyway. But they're handy if you're thick and you don't know what you're doing. Not that I'm saying that you guys are thick, by the way. I just thought I'd take that back. We have in here. Oh, it's the warranty. Warranty, don't need that. Right, now we have, she's neatly packaged in there. In this side here, there was a micro USB power. Unfortunately though, I find that with this, they should have added an aux cable or an audio cable, but they haven't done, so that's the only downside to it. Now this is her. This is the Dot. It's very small. Fit in my mouth. No. Has 4 buttons on it. Volume up, volume down, microphone mute button, and that circle one on the right, the left to you, is the command button if you don't want to say the wait word. And at the back, it is just a power cable slot. There we go, sorry, can't see. That's the micro USB slot and the audio cable. So let's just get her powered up. I keep her in the hallway because I have a shelf put on there anyway, so she can reach both bedroom and the lounge then, which is handy. Now let's go ahead and plug her in. On the initial startup, obviously it won't do it, but you have to get the app. Where is my phone? There. The app, you need to get Amazon Alexa, available on Android and iOS. The Amazon Alexa app is there. No, it's not, that's the light yet, there. I don't know, I'm getting closer so you can see. It's just right there, you need to get that. And if, yeah, sorry, I do have Tinder. So you open that up, and it'll open up with Amazon Alexa. And then it has on-screen instructions of what to do. All this wouldn't be up. This is the history of Alexa I've been using throughout the week. All this won't be up. It will just come up as connect a new device, which I'll show you how to show that now. Set up new device. That's what it'll come up as. You can either set the Echo, the Tab, or the Echo Dot. Tap the Echo Dot, and then just follow the on-screen instructions until she's set up. Don't plug it in until it tells you to plug it in. It's quite an easy setup. I find, let's move the phone out of the way so it's not on the screen. So I'm gonna go and plug her in. Plug her in. I'll just get my cable. This is the one I use to charge micro USB things like the speaker I have. I'll show you in a minute. Let's go and plug her in. Stay there, don't roll. It should flash orange. Hopefully. No, blue. On initial startup, she would light orange till you found the Wi-Fi and all that, but it tells you all that on the app what to do. So now that's plugged in, You want to pair it with, you can either use the normal speaker that's in the box, or you can pair it to a Bluetooth speaker. So let's move her to the side. Here I go. It's the welcoming sound.
Hello.
Hello. She's just saying hello now because she's already configured to my Wi-Fi. She would say, welcome, please get Alexa app, I think she said, to continue, which is handy, which is good, it tells you. But this is my speaker I have. It's just a Sony speaker ball. Yep. So if I turn this on, let's go, Alexa, connect to Bluetooth speaker.
Searching.
Now make sure this is in pair mode if it's a new speaker. Now that's connected. See the blue light at the bottom? Hold on. Blue light at the bottom means it's connected. It was flashing red and blue before. So that's connected. You can ask her stupid things. I found out one the other day. I'm just gonna, Alexa, disconnect from Bluetooth speaker. Because that speaker's quite
now
loud.
Now disconnected I'm from Sony SRS her. X1.
Okay, thanks. I'm just gonna use her her internal speaker for now. The reason why I use it, because I keep the speaker in here plugged in, and she's in the hallway, and I can hear her a bit better through the speaker, which is handy. What was I saying? Oh yeah, the thing I found out you could talk to her about was stuff like, you know, what's the first rule of Fight Club? She answers you to it. She answers it. I'll just show you. Alexa, what's the first rule of Fight Club?
Don't talk about Fight Club.
She has a wicked sense of humour. You can do much more. Unfortunately, when you plug her in, she doesn't know who she is, what she is. You have to get, it tells you all on the app anyway, but you have to get skills, enable skills, so she knows, like skills like Spotify and the news and your location, stuff like that. So that's the only downside. You can't just plug her in and play. You have to get her enabled with different loads of different skills. Most of them are free. If you're Prime member on Amazon, all of them are free. But now I'm going to talk about the TP. I'm going to talk about the TP link now. I have taken this out, so I'm not going to open the box. Unfortunately, I couldn't set it up by myself. But this is it. This retails at, I bought it at $29.99. Yes, it's a lot for one plug. But what it does, it's awesome. You can control it through Alexa, or you could stop.
I didn't quite catch that.
I'm going to have to use the Amazon Echo word so she doesn't activate. Yeah, you control this through the phone, or you can control it through the Amazon Echo. This is really handy for me. This is the main reason why I got an Amazon Echo. I'll show you later on the video anyway, but yeah, this can control any plug socket, UK and the American as well. The two prongs. You can control any outlet in the house or through using Wi-Fi. It's quite easy to set up. First, open the box. Obviously, I'm not going to open it. Get the app TP-Link Casa, it's called. There is a QR code inside the box as well. So once you got that, it's the same way of Alexa, you know, set it up with the Wi-Fi. It's all on screen, which is handy. And that's pretty much it. I did find that on the app, it doesn't tell you. If you want to use it with Alexa, you have to... She didn't activate. Keep saying it. If you want to use it with the Amazon Echo, you have to enable on the app remote. And then the Amazon Echo can then control it for you instead of using the app, which is handy for me. The big tall Amazon Echo, the first one, that retails at about £129 on Amazon. This one was $49.99. Right, I'm just going to turn the camera around and I'll show you how the TP Link works. I have called this living room cabinet because it's in the living room and it's a cabinet. First of all, you have to say the awake word and then just say turn off or turn on and then whatever you've called the plug socket, it'll do it that way. So if I go, Alexa, turn off living room cabinet.
Okay.
and she'll give you feedback afterwards to say, tell you that she has done it in case you're in another room or whatever. I can't physically reach behind the cabinet and turn it off at the wall. So, yeah. Alexa, turn on living room cabinet.
Okay.
So there you go, guys. People like me, as you've just seen the demonstration there, this is extremely handy for me. So that's the main reason why I've got it. I actually can play music as well, like Alexa, play Queen from Spotify.
Playing songs by Queen from Spotify.
There you go. Is this the real and now you can say, Alexa, volume 1. God, that's quiet. Still playing though. Alexa, volume 10. There you go. And is that still on? Yeah. Alexa, connect to Bluetooth speaker.
Quite searching.
Quick. Quite quick too. There you go. Alexa, disconnect from Bluetooth speaker.
Now disconnected.
That's how easy
Sony
it is.
SRS X1.
To connect to speaker. That simple. Alexa, stop. And she'll stop. She can also tell you the weather. Alexa, what's the weather like today?
Right now, it's 3 degrees with mostly cloudy skies. Today's forecast has clouds with a chance of showers, with a high of 6 degrees and a low of 2 degrees.
I've just given my location away there. I'm going to have to bleep that. She can also tell you the news as well, but I'm not going to do that because it goes on forever. Sky News, you can pick what news you want to know. She can read you the Daily Mail, the Telegraph, Sky News and Sky Sports as well. I use her mainly as well for shopping lists. Like, Alexa, add TP-Link plug to my shopping list.
Okay, I added TP-Link plug to your shopping list.
There you go. And I can add another one, say, Alexa, add butter to my shopping list.
Got it. I put butter on your shopping list.
There you go. And she can say, I can then, if I've forgotten what I've put on, I can say, Alexa, what's on my shopping list?
You have 2 items on your shopping list. Butter, TP, Link Plug.
And there you go, that's that. I'm in love with Amazon Echo. This is how much she loves me. Alexa, do you love me?
There are people I admire and things I can't do without, but I'm still trying to figure out human love. It makes Goldbach's conjecture look easy.
You listen here, right? If I say I love you, you say it back.
I love you.
Thank you very much. Now that, ladies and gentlemen, is Bond, right? That is how you make a Bond with an Amazon Echo. Well, that's about it, guys. I'm sorry it's a bit of a long video, I'm afraid. I just wanted to get everything out there so you understood what I was talking about. Anyway, if you liked this video, please smash that like button down below. Even if you didn't enjoy this video, smash that like button down below. Snapchat and Instagram links are coming up on the screen now. And yeah, as always, thank you very much for watching, and don't forget to keep it wheeling.
Don't forget, subscribe for more content.
You heard the lady.